Hey, Brock the Owl, Brock the Owl Show. Brock the Owl, Brock the Owl Show. Brock the Owl, Brock the Owl Show. Okay, double honesty, the apostles of great millstone. Honesty above is to be pushing his truth and sincerity throughout the four corners of the earth. And all praises unto Yahweh Baal Shem Yahshai. So this is the continuation from the last video that I had did. And I wanted to continue from where I had left off within the book of 1 Peter, the first chapter. And the seventh verse on down, again, I might split up even more. You know, I want to keep this, you know, short, okay? And then, you know, do the last ones, you know, the last bits of this chapter, you know, later on during the week. So I believe we was around about the sixth verse, okay? I'll read from the sixth verse and then just, you know, go with the Spirit. So it says, humble yourselves, this is 1 Peter 5 and 6. It says, humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of Yahweh, that he may exalt you in due time. Okay, so you come into this truth, okay? You know, the scripture says that knowledge profiteth up. The scripture also speaks about how you're supposed to be fighting toward humility. And I believe I spoke about this earlier on within the first video that I did on this the most recent video, okay, in my list. And pretty much I was going into the fact that if you're really supposed to be in this thing, the Most High will humble you. That's why you go to the scriptures like the book of 2 Peter's, the book of Ecclesiastes, the second chapter. And the scripture says that what? When you come to the serve your Yahweh Shem Yahshai, you're supposed to prepare your mind for temptation, because that temptation, right, is dual purpose, okay? The dual purpose of it is that it's going to guarantee you're going to be humble, man, okay? That's why you had cats within the scriptures going back onto the times of the apostles that was talking about how their infirmities, okay, was to the end that they weren't going to be puffed up, okay? And the same thing applies for when you come into this truth. So when you see a guy is puffed up, okay, it's usually, okay, not always, but it's usually because really that person ain't within this truth, okay? Now you got, you know, diversities of spirit, okay, and you're always going to have it to where, you know, you're going to have clashes and this, that, and the third, but if a guy is proud on a day-to-day basis every day and he's going to talk about himself, then you got to watch a dude like that. And that goes for myself too, okay? It says, casting all your care upon Yahweh, okay, for he careth for you, okay? So when you have it to where you got these adversity coming up, okay, and the Most High is seeing it to where, you know, he's putting that humility on you, by way of the adversities, then the first thing, you know, that you should be doing is casting your burdens, okay, unto Yahweh, unto the Most High. Because really, when you go into the scriptures, you know, scriptures like 2 Samuel's 2 and 6, okay, where the scripture says, the Lord killeth and he maketh life, the scripture goes also to say that the Most High raises it up from the ground, okay, and it is Yahweh Bashin Yahshai that puts into the ground, okay? The Most High is the one that sanctions the promotion, okay? So you're talking about, you know, a work-related issue or a family-related issue or whatever problem that it might be. The fact of the matter is that Yahweh Hashem Yahshai is the one, okay, that's going to resolve all of these different problems, because when you really want to go into it, he's the one that's created the aforesaid issue in the first place. Because he's the one that controls everything. So you're supposed to cast all your so-called difficulties, if you will, okay, unto Yahweh Hashem Yahshai. And he's going to be the one that's going to really be, you know, solving all of those things out, okay? It says, be sober, be vigilant, okay, because your adversary, the devil, okay, walketh around like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. It says, and I believe I went into that before, okay, dealing with how, you know, the society that we're living in right now. Okay, this ain't a great place to be living in. This ain't no a holiday inn. This ain't no holiday resort where you're gonna be chilling, man. Okay, the spiritual demon Satan's gonna be sent to attack you. Okay, the very society that we're living in is designed, okay, to be grievous, and it's designed to be what? It's designed to be basically putting you into a mindset where you're not gonna be wanting. Okay, to be spiritual. Okay, this is the most wicked kingdom that's ever existed. To the end of the scripture says within the book of Amos, the ninth chapter and the eighth verse. Okay, the Lord the eyes of the Lord are upon the sinful kingdom, and he's going to destroy it from off the face thereof. Okay, but the Most High of so this is the ninth verse. Whom resisted steadfast in the face, knowing that some affliction are accomplished, okay, in your brethren that are in the world. It says, but the Most High of all grace, who have called us unto his eternal glory by Yahushua Mashiach, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect and establish you and settle you, because through the adversity you is going to be made perfect. Okay, you go to the book of Zechariah, the 13th chapter. Zechariah, the 13th chapter is a good scripture, because it goes to show you that everybody was going to go through the fire, okay? But there's two different fires. There's the fire of adversity that was going to come upon the men of the Lord as they was going to be teaching this word on this side. And then there comes the fire of the nuclear weapons, which is going to, you know, lead unto the everlasting contempt of the people that fall out of this truth, okay? And they're going to go through the fire, the fire of the nuclear weapons, man. Okay, now they're going to come through. When you go to the scriptures within the book of, Isaiah, the 14th chapter, you find out that all Israel is going to make it. Okay, but there's going to be guys that are going to be cut off from the stronghold of, they're going to be cut off on this side, the one third. Okay, and they're going to be what? And they're going to be born as newborn babies. But, you know, the scripture says that what? They're going to know that, man. Okay. So let's carry on here with the scriptures. This is the 11th verse. It says, to him be the glory and the dominion forever, right? And forever to what? Okay, so pretty much that's the video, okay? And now let me just touch some supporting precepts, okay, to this video, okay, to this chapter, because, you know, pretty much all the points that I wanted to hit within this particular chapter have been hit. So I can now go into the different precepts, okay, to go into the different topics that are related to this, okay? Now let's start off with that precept that I had quoted within the book of Isaiah, the 14th chapter. And, you know, I might have done this on the previous video as well too, you know, the part one. Okay, so this is the book of Isaiah, the 14th chapter, and this is the first verse. So it says here, the Lord will have mercy upon Jacob, and we yet choose Israel, and set them in their own land, and the strangers shall be joined unto them. But we also know through the book of Zechariah, the 13th chapter, okay, and I quoted this a little bit earlier on too, Zechariah 13 and 8, it says that what? And I'll bring the third part through the fire, okay, and I'll refine them as silver is refined, and try them as gold is tried. And they shall call upon my name, and I'll hear them, and I'll say, it is my people, and they shall say, it is the Lord our power. Okay, so this goes to show you that what? That the men of the Lord, the one third, are gonna be going through adversities, which is gonna keep you humble. Okay, the adversities are not only gonna keep you humble, they're also gonna purify you. Remember, the scripture says, be ye perfect, your Father in heaven is perfect. Okay, so this is what these adversities are gonna be on. But see what the scripture says, it says. It says that what? It says that call upon my name. And when we was in the book of 2 Peter, the 5th chapter, what does the scripture say? All right, it was going into the fact that, let's get it right quick. Okay, it was going into the fact that you're supposed to be casting your burdens upon upon the Lord. So it says there, 1 Peter, rather more 5 and 7, it says casting all your care upon him. That's where we was going into the book of Zechariah, the 13th chapter, you're saying the men of the Lord, the elect, was going to call upon Yahweh Shem Yahshai, okay? Because that was going to be your defense in times of adversities, man, okay? Right, going back onto that scripture now, okay, in Zechariah, the 13th chapter, okay, and we'll finish up in a second. All right, bear with me. Okay, Zechariah. Go back. Take me back. Okay, Zechariah, the 13th chapter now. And back at the 8th verse, it says, I'll read from the 8th verse this time. So it says, it shall come to pass, then all the land saith the Lord, that two parts therein shall be cut off and die, and the third part shall be left therein. So we know that that's talking about the elect. And the scripture says that I'll bring the third part through the fire, and we explain all of that. Okay? And I'll refine them as silver is refined, and I'll try them as gold is tried. And you also go to the book of Isaiah, the 13th chapter. What does it say? A man shall be as what? it shall be as likened unto gold, man. Okay, and that also goes into the fact that when this war happens, this World War III, okay, what you Christians call the so-called rapture, when you have these things play out, what's going to happen to the population of the world is going to drop down significantly. So when you have it to where you've got a few men and all of these women around, the value of a man, okay, is going to be increased. Okay, you're going to have a son and the man's going to be glorified, but you're going to be happy to have a son. Not like how you're living within this society when, you know, people look down upon men and this, that, and the third. Okay, when you got mass depopulation because of war and all of these men, you know, die off and you only got the elect saved through, that value is going to go up and be increased, which mirrors the precept where the scripture talks about how a man was going to be like gold. Okay, but the fire that the man of the Lord is going to go through was going to be the furnace of adversity. Okay, it says, and I'll try them as gold is tried, and they shall call upon my name because we're going to cast our burdens upon Yahweh. He's the one that was going to deliver us from the situations that we're in. Okay, and I'll hear them and I will say, it is my people, and they shall say, it is our Lord, our power. Okay, so with that, I'm going to say, double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone. Honest, your brothers will be pushing this truth in sincere. All praise unto Yahweh Hashem Yahshua. Double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone. Okay, and honest, your brothers will be pushing this truth in sincere. Shalom.